again and welcome back to SFF 180. It is Monday, November the 8th, and time once again for the mailbag. And yeah, you are getting an evening mailbag tonight. Apologies for that. Not the usual 7 a.m. upload. It's just the weekend was very exhausting for me due to one thing or another having nothing to do with any of my production commitments here. But anyway, here you are. And I would say that it's a good average-sized mailbag. I have maybe three or four physical packages and about five e-arcs, I think. So we're going to get through these pretty quickly. Don't really have any announcements at the moment, except to say, I'm very pleased with the new schedule. Now that I have committed to the bi-weekly schedule for the mailbags, I feel like I've gotten the production mojo back, right? Since the last one, you guys have had the interview with Marshall Maresca, as well as two review videos. And now this week and next week, I've got more review videos on tap. So I feel like, I'm kind of back in the saddle in terms of production, and it feels really good. So I'm hoping to keep that momentum up. All right. Anyway, without further ado, then let's go ahead and get into the books. And this first one is a little envelope with some stuff in it from Neon Hemlock Press. Okay, so this looks to be two new entries in a Neon Hemlock's novella series, and they are very beautiful editions indeed. This first one here is a new book by Wendy N. Wagner. It is called The Secret Skin, and it describes itself as a sawmill gothic. I guess we'll find out what that means here right now. Okay. After June Vogel's return to Storm Break, her family's estate, it becomes clear that things in the great house aren't what they used to be. Doors slam in the night, faucets turn on, untouched, something is always watching, whatever June does. And when her brother returns with his new bride, deceit and betrayal threaten to destroy everything June loves. All right, so it sounds like it is a modern gothic in a very classic mode here from Wendy N. Wagner, but this is The Secret Skin. And the next one is called And This Is How to Stay Alive. And the author is Shingai Njeri Kagunda. All right. And what's this one all about? It says, Naokabi's world unravels after her brother Baraka's death by suicide, when an eccentric auntie gives Naokabi a potion that sends her back in time when Baraka was still alive. It becomes her only goal to keep him that way. But Kabi soon learns that while storytellers may be the carriers of time, defying the past comes with its own repercussions. All right, and this is how to stay alive. And so those are the two latest, it looks like, in Neon Hemlock's ongoing series now of fantasy, dark fantasy, modern gothic novellas. And next up, I have two white envelopes from the Macmillan Group. And first up, we have The Undertakers. This is Nicole Glover's sequel to The Conductors. It's the second volume in her Murder and Magic series, set during post-Civil War Reconstruction. And let's see, it goes like that. What can I read that is not going to be a spoiler? Oh, probably most of it. It says, the Civil War is over, but its legacy casts a deadly shadow over the streets of Philadelphia. And the hotly anticipated follow-up to The Conductors. I've actually been really looking forward to reading these. For Hetty and Benji Rhodes, no case involving strange magic or mysterious circumstances is too difficult. But the death of Raymond Duval, a victim of one of the many magic-resistant fires that have erupted recently in Philadelphia, is too easily solved. Hetty and Benji's investigation points directly to a powerful fire company known to let homes in the black community burn to the ground, particularly when they're connected to the growing magic rights movement. As Raymond was a vocal advocate of teaching celestial magic in schools, the answer seems obvious, and Hetty and Benji put the case aside until Raymond's son is found dead too. Suspicious of the timing and certain that the deaths of father and son are connected, Hetty and Benji renew their investigation. Their search leads them to a network of forgotten tunnels beneath the city, where long-buried secrets come to light and dredge up dangerous ghosts that are not easily banished, even with the strongest of spells. Sounds like this one might be able to be read as a standalone, even though it's a sequel. But either way, it is available now. The Undertakers by Nicole Glover. It's an amazing looking cover, too. And next, here's an interesting one to follow up with. This is Orson Scott Card's The Last Shadow. We all know our issues with Orson Scott Card, right? So I guess I've just, you know, I'll go ahead and showcase this. They've sent it to me. It is the long-awaited conclusion, he swears. This is maybe the many, many times now that he has sworn this series is over. To the Ender Saga and the Shadow series, the original saga, okay? It's called The Last Shadow. It's available, I guess, now in hardcover from Tor. And finally, we have this one in from HarperCollins. And it's really nice to have this one in the house, the finished copy of Neal Stephenson's new tome, Termination Shock. This is only 700 pages, so I guess it's short for him. But let's just go through it again. It is described as a sweeping, prescient new novel that transports readers to a near-future world in which the greenhouse effect has inexorably resulted in a whirling dervish troposphere of superstorms, rising sea levels, global flooding, merciless heat waves, and virulent deadly pandemics. One man, visionary billionaire restaurant chain magnate T.R. Schmidt, Ph.D., has a big idea for reversing global warming, a master plan perhaps best described as elemental. But will it work? And just as important, what are the consequences for the planet and all of humanity should it be applied? Ranging from the Texas heartland to the Dutch royal palace in The Hague, from the snow-capped peaks of the Himalayas to the sun-baked Chihuahuan desert, Termination Shock brings together a disparate, but they probably are also desperate, group of characters from different cultures and continents who grapple with the real-life repercussions of global warming. Ultimately, it asks the question, might the cure be worse than the disease? Well, I guess it depends on the cure, right? Epic in scope, while heartbreakingly human in perspective, Termination Shock sounds a clarion alarm, ponders potential solutions and dire risks, and wraps it all together in an exhilarating, witty, mind-expanding, speculative adventure. All right, and there you have it, Termination Shock from Neal Stephenson. I guess available now, or maybe tomorrow, as of tomorrow, from... No, wait. There's no actual sell sheet in here, so I'm going by memory. I do believe it is next Tuesday, a week from tomorrow, that this will be out in stores. Okay, now on to the e-arcs. Like I said, I think I only have about 5 of these, but before I get into those, have something a little bit different. I had the author, the creator of this, reached out to me, and I said, okay, yeah, I'll give it a shout-out. A fellow named Jacob White is doing an online web serial, fantasy serial, called A Many Tale, a fantasy serial. It says, a cosmic fantasy chronicled from the perspective of a strangely intelligent mouseling named Opaline. A world walker cursed to blip from universe to universe and time to time, Opaline is thrown between planets and dimensions as well as years and epochs at a whim's notice. A time-traveling vagabond against his will, Opaline searches for purpose in his misadventurous quests, conversations, and interactions with people mostly peculiar he meets along the way. And like I said, it's a website. I'll go ahead and link it below. There are a few episodes, I think, already up that you guys can check out for yourself if you like. But that's A Many Tale, created by Jacob White, a fantasy, cosmic fantasy web serial. All right. Now, next up, we have From Orbit on January the 11th. We have A Practical Guide to Conquering the World by K.J. Parker. All right. Now, this is the third volume in the sequence of books that began with 16 Ways to Defend a Walled City and How to Rule an Empire and Get Away with It. It says it can be read by itself, but for those who like endings, it can also be considered the refreshingly pragmatic conclusion to this trilogy. It says it's the true story of Aemilius Felix Boyanis, the younger, the intended and unintended consequences of his life, the bad stuff he did on purpose, and the good stuff that happened in spite of him. It is, in other words, the tale of a war to end all wars and the man responsible. And that will be out from Orbit on January the 11th. And also from Orbit, here's one I'm looking forward to, on February the 1st. It's Azura Ghost by Essa Hansen. It's the sequel to Nofek Gloss, an interesting space opera. A young man on the run finds himself on the wrong side of his former best friend's gun. In this action-packed space opera perfect for fans of The Expanse, yay, and a long way to a small angry planet. Okay. Kaden has been on the run for 10 years with his unique starship in order to keep his adversary Thray imprisoned. But when an old friend he'd once thought dead reappears, he is lured into a game of cat and mouse with the one person whose powers rival Thray's, Thray's sister, Abris. Now with both siblings on the hunt for Kaden and his ship, Kaden must rescue his long-lost friend from their clutches and uncover the source of both his ship's power and his own origins in order to stop Abris's plan to collapse the multiverse. All right, sounds very drastic. But anyway, that is Azura Ghost by Essa Hansen, and it will be out from Orbit on February the 1st. Now moving ahead to March, we have two books coming out on the 15th. To keep an eye out on, and they're both from Tor. The first of these is The Thousand Eyes by A.K. Larkwood. It is the sequel to The Unspoken Name. The Thousand Eyes continues the Serpent Gates series, perfect for fans of Jen Lyons, Joe Abercrombie, and Ursula K. Le Guin. 2 years ago, Sorway and Ashuthmili. This fantasy names, guys. Look, I love fantasy as much as you guys, right? But every once in a while, sometimes it seems like just fantasy authors are like, "Why? I'll just kind of scramble letters and come up with character names at random." Anyway, these characters risked the anger of the wizard Belthandros Sethanai to gain their freedom. Now they make their living exploring relic worlds of the ancient serpent empire of Eshentir. Okay, so anyway, you've got these two characters, and their adventures continue in, I guess, the acclaimed debut, the sequel to the acclaimed debut fantasy, The Unspoken Name. That is The Thousand Eyes, the author's A.K. Larkwood, and it's available on March the 15th. And also on March the 15th, we have The Kaiju Preservation Society, new book by John Scalzi. His first standalone adventure since the conclusion of his New York Times bestselling Interdependency trilogy. When COVID-19 sweeps through New York City, Jamie Gray is stuck as a dead-end driver for food delivery apps. That is, until Jamie makes a delivery to an old acquaintance, Tom, who works at what he calls an animal rights organization. Tom's team needs a last-minute grunt to handle things on their next field visit. Jamie, eager to do anything, immediately signs on. What Tom doesn't tell Jamie is that the animals his team cares for are not here on Earth, not our Earth at least. In an alternate dimension, massive dinosaur-like creatures named Kaiju roam a warm and human-free world. They're the universe's largest and most dangerous panda, and they're in trouble. It's not just the Kaiju Preservation Society who's found their way to the alternate world. Others have too, and their carelessness could cause millions back on our Earth to die. All right, so being a Scalzi novel, I'm sure you can expect the usual, a mixture of snarky humor mixed with big action, sentimental moments, right? So, in all, just a good time. But the Kaiju Preservation Society will be available from Tor on March the 15th. Okay. And finally, we have, also from Tor, we're looking way ahead, on August the 9th, we have a book called The Book Eaters. The author is Sunyi Dean, and it is described as a contemporary fantasy. It's a story of motherhood, sacrifice, and hope, of queer identity and learning to accept who you are, of gilded lies and the danger of believing the narratives others create for you. Out on the Yorkshire moors lives a secret line of people for whom books are food, and who retain all of a book's content after eating it. Wow, I envy them already. To them, spy novels are a peppery snack. Romance novels are a sweet and delicious. Eating a map can help them remember destinations, and children, when they misbehave, are forced to eat dry, musty pages from dictionaries. Devon is part of The Family, an old and reclusive clan of book eaters. Her brothers grew up feasting on stories of valor and adventure, and Devon, like all other book eater women, is raised on a carefully curated diet of fairy tales and cautionary stories. But real life doesn't always come with happy endings, as Devon learns when her son is born with a rare and darker kind of hunger, not for books, but for human minds. And that is The Book Eaters by Sunyi Dean, and it will be out from Tor way ahead on August the 9th. So go ahead and, I guess, if you're interested, mark your Goodreads now. And there you have it. That's all I have for the very first mailbag of November. You guys know the drill. Light up those comments. Let me know which of these looks most interesting and exciting to you, and which you would like to see me prioritize for review. Otherwise, if you enjoyed watching, please hit the like button, share, and subscribe. If you have not done so, that is how the channel grows. And you can also support the channel at my TeePublic store and at my Patreon, where recruits into Winx Army get little perks, like occasionally they'll get to see early access on some of my videos if I'm not running a day late. But otherwise, I really do want to thank those people for their added support, because I use the Patreon money to pay Matt Olson, my very gifted and talented channel artist who does all of my beautiful thumbnails and animations for me and really gives the channel its character. So thank you all. I want to thank all the rest of you for being the very best viewers in all of BookTube. And until I see you next time, please stay safe and healthy. And happy reading.